world of difference. You must ask yourself every morning, why am I waking up today? You may want to have a happy patient. Before that, you have to be a happy person. A patient would be happy only to see a happy doctor. So for that, it's very, very important. The minute you step into your working environment, you're happy. Like you see a player, he must have got out for a previous game. Doesn't matter when he takes the next crease, he's fresh to face the ball. He doesn't, you know, the world or the bowler doesn't care whether you scored 100 last innings or zero. You have to deal with a new ball. Similarly, as you become a doctor, your job is to come smiling, irrespective of what has happened, irrespective of what people say. You're not expected to lose your cool. You're expected to answer with as much dignity as possible. Second, make it as best as it can become, because then you're the highest educated person in that given system. Trust that. Nobody is more educated than you in that system. Right? So don't expect your nurse, your executive or any administrator to do it on your behalf. And you've dealt with this process day in and day out. So if you find your salvation, your patients will always be happy, your organization will be happy. You're not here to please somebody. You're here to become the best that you can become every day and practice it every day and go back home. All of us will learn, all of us will have a good life. Don't worry about it. The challenge for us is to make that place, when I step in, when I leave, that place has become better than when I enter. That is the goal of any educated person to go to work, right? So that is part of internal growth that needs to happen. Second, as a young doctor, there are different kinds of people. Some you need to tell every day, delegate their responsibility, and if they complete that, it's a great achievement. But there are many others, you know, who know what is to be done. You don't even have to tell them. And there are a lot more people I have seen. They even do the job, consultants' jobs. And when the consultant goes, patients are happy to see the resident or the registrar. And even the lift man salutes the resident because he hardly sees the consultant. You know, it's even happened to me when I go to the sixth floor. The nurse doesn't know who this guy is, but she knows all my registrars. But that's how you mix. You need to know where you add value, you go there, right? Because that's where you make maximum difference. Secondly, don't expect things to be in order when you come to work. Otherwise, you don't have a role to work there if everything goes in a very orderly manner. You must expect to come and face 10 problems every morning and fix them, not hand it over to the next person. You're not here to pass on the baton to somebody. You're a good doctor if you can fix the problem and it is completed in full stop. The challenge of today's education has been told that they teach you the science, but the practice is not taught. You're expected to work with big institutions or guys who have established themselves and learn from them how to do it. I think more of it is to do what you get inspired at home or school than what you learn in working environment. What I have found in my life is that it is my personal salvation that I do what I do, not for what it brings in return. Second, keeping the patient happy is very, very crucial, because a person who is happy, he will do what is expected of him without complaining. So for that, all he needs is about 10-15 minutes of yours. You know, as a doctor, all I need to do, I tell my colleagues, and if I have a chance, I do, pull a chair and sit next to him when I go for rounds. Not stand, hold his hand and say, all good, come back. It's very easy. If a patient is admitted with me, I think once in 3 days at least, I need to pull a chair, sit with him, talk to him, feel him. Because my mom told me when I became a doctor, Girish, I don't know what doctor tells me. I want to be understood that he has heard me. If a patient does not feel that you have listened to the patient, how do you think that he will believe that I'll be treated or cured? So it's very important as a doctor, you know, as a old doctor, as a young doctor, I tell you, When you go to the wrong, just greet, tell them, good morning, how are you, I'm happy. You know, you need to see a happy face, right? Second, go look for what value you can add on top of what has already been done, right? And secondly, see whose work I can unburden. And never say that this is what I'm paid for. Most often the challenge here is what they believe is, oh, this is my job definition. Beyond me, this has to go here. Or some people take their job as an authority.